Hello friends, welcome to TechnoEye channel. Today we will discuss more about component in BUEG's JavaScript framework. Before that, let me tell you a little bit about my IDE setup. I'm using Visual Studio Code and this is my Chrome browser. I'm using some styles here to make a dark theme, and this is my inspector. Okay. And here I am writing my HTML, and this is my JavaScript code. And in this initial sections, I have added the style sheet and referring to my JavaScript program. So this is the method I am executing. So this is my small component, and this is my application instance. You can watch my previous videos to get into step-by-step instruction if you are not familiar with this stuff. Okay. So I'll continue from where I left. Okay, so I'm referring as this application instance, and here I'm accessing this name variable. That's where John is getting printed, and this tn slot is my component. Okay, so this h1 my component is getting printed, and here in Vue.js we can define our own template. Is not if you have a little bit bigger template, it is not feasible to write all over here. And because of some performance reason, Vue.js doesn't support template URI or ULL like Angular.js. So that you can refer to any other HTML code. There are some issue on that. So we can use a template tag. We can use any tag for the matter, but template is the template tag we can use along with Vue.js, and we can define some ID. Okay, so for example, you can specify anything or not tn slash example maybe. So whatever I have write, so it will be display over here. So we can just give id notation tn example. Okay, so I can refer to this id, and here I can define h1 element. This is my post template. Let me reload this. So this is working as earlier, but instead of writing the code over here, I can write the template in my HTML and referring over here. Okay, so you can pass the variable and we can do whatever we like to do. Now let me try to create another h2 tag. This is second header. Let me reload. But if you notice over here, this is not getting printed, right? If you like to, because this two block level element surrounded by template won't be possible to render it, so that you have to encapsulate inside a division tag, then it will work properly. So we can create a root level element. So I hope you should remember this. So now this is second header is coming up, because there is no major change I have done. Instead of the template, you should have one root level element, and you can create as many as h1 button, any the tag that is possible now. Okay, now we have using this particular tn component, tn slot, in this particular division tag where we are referring the Vue instance. This is the scope of this element, right? And for example, if you like to type any information here, this is great, or sorry, message from parent. Okay, let me reload it. So nothing will be getting printed over here. If you see element tag, if I expand here, see the John is getting displayed from this name, and this tn slot, this h1 h2 is getting printed along with the division. But this message from parent is not displayed or not even come in the render. This is a template, so it is a document fragment, and this is the structure. It will be also available inside your HTML thing. Okay, so if you like to print the message inside here, so what you can do, you have to define a slot. Okay, slot. This is the slot. So you can keep anywhere this slot tag. In slot tag means what are the messages you print that will be displayed over here. Let me reload the space. Now you can see message from the parent. Or we can the slot move to the beginning one. So let me reload. So this message from parent is coming over here. Also, we can see give some filler text. If for example you don't, let me tell you. Now if you reload, nothing will happen. But for example, if you not specify anything else over here and we reload it, so filler text will come here, come up. So this is the default text. Okay, so this slot is really important whenever you are planning to create layout and intercomponent communications, and we'll discuss in detail. Hope you understand about the slot concept. So we define a template and we can reorganize slot. So whatever the information will pass here, this is the info. So this is the info. Okay, so this is the magic of the slot. Also, is the slot is quite important. Let me get rid of this two thing. So what we can do, we can assign some name. Okay, slot. And we can define some name here, first slot, anything you can give. So this is my filler text, and forget about it. So let me get rid of this as well. Okay, so I have created a slot and I given a name. Okay, so now let me reload it. Okay, now the information whatever we are presenting over here is not appearing, right? Even though we have defined a slot, it's not coming. So what we can do, or we can't only always put the text. So we can create a division, and inside this division we may want to put this information. If you load it, still it won't come. If you would like to pass this information, this is info, to this slot, we have to give the slot name here. So slot we can call, and we can give first name. Remember, here in this template we are using name attribute, and here inside our main HTML we are using the slot attribute, and in the slot we are giving the first name. And this is the info will be getting printed. So let me reload it. Instead of this, let me try to change sometime. Okay, so I think it is not taking, you know, the name as two characters separated by hyphen. No worry, be a little bit careful, and you can check the documentation to follow the naming convention, but use simple name, it should be good enough. Okay, slot name. So then you can create as many as this name. So because if you have, let's say, h1, this is header 1, h2, this is header 2, and we can create another header, control C, second. Okay, let me copy, paste here, slot 2, and we can use second. Okay, now let me reload. So if you see over here, even though we have mentioned the slot 2 in the beginning of these two elements, this is appearing in the below, because this will be only allocated as per the HTML you define inside your template, not as per the sequence which is given here. So in the first, this is the info, so it's displayed over here, then header 1, header 2, then the second is coming from the slot 2, right? If you change it to slot 2 properties, as this was some name, so slot to property is getting changed. So this sequence is very important rather than this sequence. Okay, so if we have, let's say, any paragraph, oh, for example, or maybe ball tag. This is interesting. Okay, so I have created a, just let me get rid of this show header. Okay, so this this info is getting printed in the first, and the slot to property is printed, but this is not printed. This is interesting, is gone away. So what you can do, you can create a slot, and if you reload, this is interesting will be printed, because this is a kind of catch-all. This is kind of a default. If there is if you haven't specified this name as first, second and anything else, so whatever you given any other element inside this TN slot will be used over here. So this is like catch-all. If you are from programming background, you can use try catch and catch-all, right? So this is a catch-all kind of thing. This slot will be used. So whichever the element you given inside this, you know, tag, so will be get assigned over here. This is interesting. I think for today, this would be enough. So you can watch my previous videos, you can like the videos, you can subscribe to it and spread the word to the Twitter. So you can give me any suggestion, critics, anything on my comment, I'll definitely reply. And I'm going to create several of this kind of videos. Hope you enjoy it, hope you learn something, and have a wonderful day ahead. Bye-bye.